Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we are going to deal with the chapter 14 of hematology, that is blood groups. Consider subscribing to my channel for more of such medical lectures and health tips, and hit the notification bell so that you get the notification whenever I post such new videos, and I'll be posting the notes on Facebook and Instagram. Let's begin. Blood groups. Blood groups are determined by protein molecules present on the surface of RBC. So here we understand that there is some protein molecule on each RBC. Before that, we understand when blood from two individuals, for example, take a person named A and a person named B. We draw blood from each person A and person B and we mix it together. When we see the probability, in some cases we see that there is clumping, that is there is piling up of RBCs, and in some we see there is no piling up of RBCs. Now this was discovered first by Karl Landsteiner. So Karl Landsteiner discovered blood groups in 1901. He also won a Nobel Prize in 1930. So here, before starting the groups, remember about the clumping and no clumping. Now we start the ABO blood groups. This was discovered by the Karl Landsteiner. Now here we have to remember that immunological reaction. There is a antigen and an antibody reaction. So this ABO blood group is based upon the antigen-antibody reaction, which is the immunological reaction taking place in the blood. So don't forget this antigen antibody reaction. Now Landsteiner found two antigens in RBC. With these antigens are also called as agglutinogens. Now he found that there is an antigen A and an antigen B, these like different types of antigens on RBCs. Now in ABO blood group, he also noticed that the corresponding antibodies, these are also agglutinins, was seen in the serum. So basically ABO blood group is based upon antigen antibody reaction. So here the antigens are present on RBC, which are namely A and B, and antibodies are in the serum, namely anti-A, which is also alpha antibody, and anti-B, which is beta antibody. So basically, if anti-A is present with A antigen, there is clumping. However, in a body, antigen and its corresponding antibody cannot be present. That will result into clamping. So I hope you got it. A with anti-A will result into agglutination. So when he observed all these things, he thought of the law and he wrote a law. That is, if a particular antigen is present in RBC, then its corresponding antibody must be absent in serum. Now this is a law because if it is present, then agglutination will take place. That is formation of piling up of the RBCs, which is not possible. It is a disease condition in short. Now, if particular antigen is absent in RBC, the corresponding antibody must be present in serum. This is a bit of a controversial kind of point, though when we come to the Rh factor, it is not applicable in that point. Only in the Rh factor. So the two laws are such. Law 1 and the law 2, and you should remember those. Now let's understand another part, that is groups, basically the ABO group system. Now this is all based on the presence and absence of antigen A and antigen B blood. Now if A is present and B is present, based on that these are divided. Now A group means the RBC will have the antigen A. Now if antigen A is there, obviously anti-A can't be there, so anti-B should be present. Now B group, obviously B group means antigen B is present, and its opposite anti-A is the serum present in the antibody. In AB group, both A antigen and B antigen are seen on the RBC, whereas corresponding no antibody is seen. Now fourth one is the O group, which means that there is no antigen and you can see either both anti-A and anti-B in the serum. So I hope you got all the four groups: A group, B group, AB group and O group. A is A, B, AB, O. Now how to determine this? Now determination of blood group can also be named different. It is also called as blood grouping, blood typing or even blood matching. These all mean nothing but determination of the ABO group or blood grouping. Now blood typing is done on the basis of agglutination. I hope you remember the term which I said, antigen-antibody reaction, that agglutination occurs if an antigen is mixed with corresponding antibody, which, so basically if one antigen A is mixed with anti-A, then it will cause agglutination, that is clumping up, that they stick together or piling up, so which is also called as isoagglutination. So based on this, the blood group is determined. Now to determine, what you should do is, you should take the RBC from a person, then you should add it with the testing antisera. These are usually this antiserum A and antiserum B, which we get in the laboratories, the serums. So you should take the blood and mix it with antiserum A, antiserum B, and based on the results, we determine which are those blood groups. Now let's understand the results. Now, if agglutination occurs with you take blood with anti-A and you put anti-A on it, and if there is agglutination, means there is a reaction, so you mean that there is, the blood group is A. Now, if agglutination occurs with anti-B, so it means that B is present on the RBC. Now, if agglutination occurs with both A and B, then it is known as AB group. And if you mix, but if there is no agglutination at all, then it represents that it is a O group. Now, what is the importance of knowing the blood group? Now, in blood transfusion and all such, we need to understand the importance of ABO or the blood grouping system. For example, donor. The one who gives blood is the donor and the one who receives the blood is the recipient. Now here you need to understand, donor's antigen plays an important role and recipient's antibody plays the important role. While transfusing, antigen of donor and antibody of recipient are considered. Now you can remember this by antibody means body which is receiving. So remember like that, antigen of donor, antibody of the recipient. I hope you remember this.
Thus, the O group has no antigen and so no agglutination occurs, so it can give blood to any blood group, hence it is called a universal donor. But whereas the AB group has no antibody and this does not cause agglutination, so it can receive the blood from any kind of blood group, hence it is a universal recipient. Now understand transfusion reaction. Now, when mismatched blood is transfused, transfusion reaction occurs. When you take a blood of one person and another and you don't match it before and you just transfuse without knowing their blood group, what if there is if there is corresponding antibody? It will lead to transfusion, hence causing a very aggressive reactions, for example in jaundice, cardiac shock, renal shutdown and all other kind of diseases. Next we come to the Rh factor. Rh factor is an antigen present in the body and it is named like that because this was first discovered in the rhesus monkey. There are many different antigens, but here D plays an important role. Now the person with D antigen are called Rh positive and without D antigen are called Rh negative. When Rh negative person receives positive blood, the first time there is a reaction, but it is very delayed reaction.
means it doesn't cause any immediate problems, but there is small delayed reaction. But when the second time it is transfused, for example, in the same person, once he has got the reaction, very delayed reaction, and you give him the second time, but this time the reaction occurs very immediately and more aggressively. So this is a very important factor to be considered.
So in blood group, there are different types of categorization, such as Lewis blood group, MNS blood group, but as it is important, I only discussed the ABO blood group.
Thank you for watching the video, and make sure you subscribe to my channel and let me know your opinion.